my core beliefs is that strong schools are in strong communities. And from the short time that I've had interaction with everyone here at Holmdel, it feels like it is that community here. So I'm excited to get started. I'm excited to meet the kids first and foremost, and to meet their parents. And thank you for bringing me in and giving me the opportunity to do so. So I'm excited. Let's get started.
Thank you. Moving on. Item M, old business. Is there any old business that anyone has to discuss? I know there's a few things out there.
I did bring a copy of a draft of recording board meetings for the board to review. It's not on the agenda tonight, but perhaps for us to have a first reading of at our next meeting. It is a revision to the current policy to allow for the pilot of audio recordings to become a practice of audio recordings in the district. So I wanted to just provide that to you tonight. Some discussion about how long audio recordings will be kept. The policy talks about 45 days or until the time that the minutes have been, I guess, approved by the board, at which time the audio could be erased.
Where's the inconspicuous location? Where's the inconspicuous location?
Hey, Paul, question for you, because this came up when we first were talking about the recording of these meetings. While we are specifying the 45-day stipulation, the sticking point is the next paragraph in connection with litigation. Because unfortunately, well, litigation is unfortunate to begin with, but the truth of the matter is we don't know what is being said that may become the province of litigation. So, are we in any sort of jeopardy if we dispose of tapes after 45 days and then, you know, litigation occurs that's referring to tapes that had been recorded and then destroyed? Are we kind of caught in a conundrum that we have to really hold on to?
No, only if you have reasonable knowledge or a basis to believe that litigation is about to occur, perhaps, or technically, unless the litigation is actually filed, you don't have an obligation to.
So, Robert, just out of curiosity, is it then the intention of the administration to eliminate the past links that we've been collecting of past meetings, and we're only going to keep meetings for 45 days on the website? Or are we talking about a type of storage when we talk about the 45 days?
So currently, we keep them on our website for how long, Anthony?
I believe we have the current year. So we may have like 12 or something.
Right.
I mean, I think there's some, I mean, personally, it's not really an expense of storage if we have these recordings on the website the way they are currently structured. So I'm not really completely convinced that we should set a 45-day limit. I think we just keep them on as archival, as archival evidence of the meetings, and just leave them be. I can see some need to, you know, eliminate if it was a storage problem and we were filling up a closet with, you know, audio tapes, but that's not the case in today's world. It's all digital and it's all sitting on the website, and I'm sure you're using some sort of real audio server. That shows you how old I am. Some sort of server that's broadcasting it out, right? Right, Anthony? I mean, there's no real storage issue here, right?
No storage issue, but it's just a plain web server.
So is from your perspective, as someone who has to
maintain
it, there's no issue, right? How long could we store these things before it would become a problem?
We have them going back to the beginning, which is
2 years.
2 years, 3 years.
I just, my own personal recommendation to the board is I don't think we need to set a 45-day limitation. I just say let's keep them up. It's good for the public record and good for archival purposes, and there you go.
Well, I would also think it also can be a good history of the district if people want to go back. Like, I've seen different districts throughout the state. I mean, it's a little further, like, where you can see every principal from the district from, say, 1972, you know, to every board member, to every superintendent. You know, almost like a, you know, it's electronic history of the district. I mean, I know we don't have that, but, you know, something that would be a cool project for someone in the high school. You know, go do the, it's delineated in this district in this town, and I don't see this town going anywhere. So, you know, and it'll be harder and harder to remember it back to the 70s and 80s because we will all be gone at one point. So, I mean, just, you know, electronically putting it somewhere might be a good idea. God forbid you have a fire or something else, whatever, everything else. Maybe we already have it.
I just checked the website, and we have them all posted on the website going back to September 10th, 2014.
So can we see if there's a board consensus of asking the superintendent to remove the 45-day line and just keep them up forever, so to speak, or under the discretion of the board when to take any of them down?
I was thinking maybe if you take that paragraph you're speaking about, Mike, and delete the last sentence, I wouldn't take out the language that pertains to and provides protection under the state archives law. The purposes of if something does go missing, you know, there's a major disruption to our computer. I'm not even tech savvy. If there's a major disruption that results in the loss of a year's worth of recorded minutes, we would receive protection. That's why. So right now it's really, we could take out, it shall be retained for 45 days, and it may be erased. It may be. It doesn't mean it shall be erased. It's a may. So maybe you just eliminate the last sentence of that paragraph, and I think that gives us the district the protection while also addressing your concern.
Well, the way this is currently written, and this is where I would ask for the adjustment, it's written in a language that's suggesting that we're saving the video, the audio until the minutes have been approved by the board, and then at that point it's eliminated. I don't think we're using these audio recordings purely for the purposes of assisting the board secretary. I believe we are making these recordings to provide a record for the public to be able to go back and hear what was said. So I think that's where the adjustment in the language needs to be.
I think the last sentence is of your concern, and right now it says we shall retain it for 45 days, but we may hold on to it longer. So
that's fine.
I would eliminate the last sentence, which says all such recordings will be erased or destroyed. You get rid of that, and that addresses your concern, Mike, that
right.
You would rather demonstrate in policy language that we want to maintain this.
I would just, with all due respect, I would not eliminate that sentence. You can modify it. But that's an accurate statement of the law.
Yes, it is.
And I think it's important to be in there. I think you can change it to any destruction of the record will be in compliance.
I mean, going back to what Paul's saying, the last sentence is necessary because it gives us the ability to eliminate tapes down the road. What I think is the issue that I'm having is the beginning where it's saying it's only to be retained for 45 days. What I would do is I would just modify that restriction. Keep the ability for the district to eliminate tapes down the road they wish, but not establish a clock that says they're going to be eliminated 45 days. Do you see what I'm saying, Vicki? I know where you're saying.
I think the language as written addresses. I know there's a 45 days is a stickler for you, but I think the intent and the purpose you're trying to achieve is already addressed in the language that's existing. So you could take out 45. But
all right,
I think you want to make sure it's retained for a certain period of time so that the meeting minutes can be accurately recorded.
Right. I'll put it a different way. I do not want to approve a policy that has given the instruction to the administration to take down these recordings after 45 days.
We can add a sentence.
However, it needs to be clarified in this policy that you're not being instructed for that. Mm-hmm. As long as the rest of the board agrees, that's what I'm looking for.
Any other comments on the audio recordings? See none. Any other comments? The only other old business board retreat? probably have to discuss that. I think right now the date.